June, Master of Finance, Master of Science in Finance and Banking Open Day. We have this online session with some industry testimony today. So welcome to all the students and to our partners. Let me introduce what is the Master of Science idea and what is our slogan. Let me share the presentation with you. One second. Okay. So I hope you can see our slides. So our mantra is bridging the gap. So the Master of Science in Finance and Banking has, among other things, the peculiarity to close the gap between university and your future job market. How we do that? Practically during the academic year, we have our first step that is having a monthly Meet the Practitioner seminar in which our companies come to Tor Vergata, present themselves, present what they do, and also present the career of the manager that come to Tor Vergata since he left his master up to now. This year we had these four meetings, and our second step is in April after the meeting, we have a challenge with our partner Enel, in which students work together as a team to deliver a business project. Then our third step in May, so at the end of the year, we propose a one-day conference with three events. In this one-day conference, we have a practitioner and academic presenting a topic in finance. Then we have our alumni meeting, and also we have our dedicated career day. So at the end of the first year, and as well as during the second year, you can attend 8 seminars, 2 NL challenge, and 2 conferences. So with these three steps, we try to bridge the gap between what we teach in class and what you will face in your future dream job. So our idea is mainly focused to show you that when we teach you, let's say, capital asset pricing model, in some way you will use this model in your future job position, or you will have the elasticity to understand any different model because you already trained in one direction. So today we have three companies that are here to that interact in the past with us and are here to show you what they look for when they select a student coming from a Master of Science. And so we want to show you directly what you will face at the end of 2 years when you do job interview. So these are some partners that we had in the past, from asset manager to banks, data company, and so far and so on. All these partners relate to us in different ways. They come to the seminar, they come to the conference, and they do interview for us. So today we have our first testimony is Enel, is a utility company in Italy that is also working on trading. And we have Luca Pontecorvi and Carolina Reitano. So Carolina, the floor is yours. Please feel free to interview, please.
Okay. Good evening, everybody. I will try to show you some documents if I will be able. However, I'm Carolina Reitano. I'm in charge of the HR activities in Enel Global Trading Business Lines. And I'm very happy to participate to this event and to present our initiatives that we manage with the University of Tor Vergata to have the chance to keep in touch with students to explain them the kind of activities and job that Enel is able to offer to people that maybe in the future could be interested in working with. And we organize this kind of event to give the opportunity to all the students to experiment a real experience on the activities that in particular in this case the Global Trading Business Line manage, and on the same side, on the same moment, to have the opportunities to explore for the student, from the student point of view and from the HR point of view, the research of the right profiles that we are interested in including in our organization. And to this aim, I would want to give you some really few information about Enel, the mission, the values, because they are strictly linked to the kind of research, the kind of people that we are looking for to hire for Enel. Okay, I will try to show my Let me ask to my colleagues if they are able to see my presentation here now.
Yes.
Okay. Enel is a leader in the new energy world because Enel is the first network operator in the world with 7.3 million end users. Is the world's largest private player in renewables with 46 gigawatt capacity, and is the largest retail customer base worldwide, has the largest retail customer base worldwide with 70 million of customers in all the world. And Our vision is called Open Power, because Open Power is what is needed to solve some of the world's biggest challenges. What does it mean, Open Power? It means to be open up to more people, open up to new technologies, open to new ways to manage energy, open to new uses of energy, open up to new partnership. To do these, all these things, we choose four simple values. Four simple values that are the values that inspire us in our daily trip, let me say, only to joke. The trip means trust, responsibility, innovation and proactivity, but to be serious, these are the values that we want that inspires our daily work and life in the company. And to translate all these simple but very important principle in the values and attitudes that we want to search in people that we hire. The attitudes that we look for are to be able to become inspirational leader. We want to rise people and a future managerial population that is able to be inspirational, to be able to cooperate and include people and diversity, to be able to take decision and deliver solution, to be able to be strict and strongly customer oriented to be able to innovate, and they have to be, how to say, to own a personal agility. Few tips for people that wants to work with us. Be curious to be able to develop innovation and to be strictly and strongly customer oriented. Be generous to be able to become an inspirational leader and to be able to develop cooperation and inclusion. Be resilient, never give up, in the sense don't be afraid of failure, and you will be able to take decision and to deliver solution and to be agile person that they are able to create and change and make happen changes. So these are all our, how to say, best principle in open power. So you have to understand what's your power and to understand if it fits with NS1. Thank you to everybody. I think now I let the talk to Luca that will describe more precisely the kind of exercise that we will develop with you. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you, Carolina. Hello, everybody. I'm Luca Pontecorvi, and I just want to give you a very brief information about what we do and what we would like to do also with you. As Carolina said, we are a utility. We are a very big utility. We produce energy, we sell energy, but we also used to trade. This is something not very common, and actually I'm quite sure that many of you never heard that Enel has a trading room and has also a trading team, but we are a very good team. We are a lot of guys around the world, more than 100. And we buy and sell commodity. We buy and sell everything that is related to our main business. As Professor Ciceretti said, our aim here is to try to fill this gap, because many of you are going to finish their study, are going to start this great experience. But one thing that is very important is to understand that what you are going to study at the university is something that you are going to apply also in your daily life at job. Please trust me when I say that this is not very far. I know that for sure that when we first time try to share with you our problem, it seems that these are very different and very far from the academic world, but actually it's not very very different at all. In order to do that, we would like to share with you, as Professor Ciceretti said, a couple of examples of our daily problem. And the main aspect that we would like to underline with you, that we would like to study with you, is not only the technical approach to this kind of problem, but we also like to have your point of view, because as Carolina said, we are very focused on innovation. So sometimes when you deal with this kind of problem, when you start to face with this kind of a problem, having a different point of view, having a fresh point of view is very worth for us. So something that we found out in the past is that this collaboration, this synergy with the university is a very good starting point for us in order to have a very good feedback from different topics of our daily job. From your side, I would say that this would be a great experience, because you could understand how to apply your knowledge in a daily activities. And also you will have the opportunity to try to expose to share your idea with some of our managers. And this is something very, very important, because even if you are very good to do your job, the very important thing is to be able to communicate your results. So I would like to share with you, I would like to underline with you this aspect. Please understand that this opportunity is something very, very worthy, because it's important to reach good results, but at the same time, it's very important to be able to share this kind of results. And I'm looking forward to look this business case with you. And just to give you an idea how this world is very open, how this world is very variegated. I'm an engineer, and actually I'm a biomedical engineer with a PhD in biomedical engineering. So when we deal with trading, please trust me when I say that you are going to face different problem from very different perspective, and this is very worthy and would be very, very funny. So good luck, enjoy your study, and looking forward to see you.
I don't know, Rocco. And now let me give the floor to Simone. Is a deputy general manager at Monte Paschi di Siena Capital Service. Simone was our speaker last year during our quantitative finance conference, and he was also speaker this year mid practitioner seminar. So Simone, the floor is yours, please.
Yes, sorry. Thank you, Rocco. Thank you very much. Do you hear me well now?
Yes.
Okay. So thank you for inviting me in this, taking the opportunity to present myself, but most of all my organization, which is MPS Capital Service. MPS Capital Service is the investment bank of MPS Group. As you can see behind me, there is a trading room. If you can see, is quite empty now, because most of the staff are in smart working, but usually is full of people doing what? Trading, because as Luca said, in our company as well, we provide some kind of service, which is we consider ourselves as a dealer. What does it mean, a dealer? Because when I was at your age, just starting a career in a master or something specific on finance, I was full of expectation, full of knowledge of models and some other aspect, but I didn't know what an investment bank was doing. So I teach a course in Siena, where I'm located, and I usually start my course with a lesson zero. What does it mean? What are we doing? So how a bank, an investment bank, is structured? What kind of client is servicing? And so just a few minutes to try to give you a very sketch idea of what we are doing. A dealer is not an asset manager. A dealer is an intermediary which is giving a service to some clients. What kind of service is the service of providing prices on different financial assets, on derivatives, on bonds, equities, credit derivatives, on different structure of mix strategies among these instruments. So we do not invest for others. This is a kind of service that is done by asset manager. We provide the service to face client needs in terms of liquidity, and so in terms, so trying to do this business, you are trying to get the a margin, a so-called bid spread or commission, whatever, a commercial margin in order to provide liquidity to clients. So who are the clients of an investment bank? They are corporates that need to hedge themselves, to hedge the revenues, to hedge the asset or maybe liabilities, because maybe rates will increase and they need to hedge the increase in rates, or exchange rate can fluctuate in the market, they need to exchange. For example, Enel need to hedge the price of commodities in order to reduce the risk of the balance sheet or the P&L. Other clients are, for example, are asset managers themselves that need to buy and sell asset for their client. A dealer is a specific kind of player in the market. Is not a speculator, because usually dealers try to hedge themselves in a way that their value at risk will remain. Value at risk is a metric in very common in financial industry, which is the quantile of the distribution, a very large quantile of the distribution of P&L. Anyway, in order to provide services, you know what price you need to do for all the assets that you are trading. In order to understand the price, you need to know how you can get information from markets and how to calculate and to understand the fair price of different assets from tradable instruments. For this reason, together with trading and desks, it's very important the quantitative department. Usually, they are the person in charge of developing models, developing pricing routines, implementing into the risk management system that traders use. And another important part of the dealer, industry is the sales department, because when you trade something, you need someone who is in charge of getting the client, facing the client, try to let them know that you are able to provide the service. In order, obviously, salesperson is important that they know what they are going to sell, and so they are not just commercial salesperson, but they need to understand and they need to be able to explain to others the contents of the service that you provide and the concept of the product. So at the end, it's the basic foundation that you are going to study and that you have studied in the past, but maybe in more depth in the future, are important, because they are used every day in the financial community. Maybe even more complicated, sophisticated that you expect, especially with respect to, for example, models, mathematical models that we use. They have technical aspect that even mathematical. With a strong mathematical background, that they are very, very difficult. But you know that there is a sort of let's say grading of what you can do with your knowledge. Maybe if you are more keen to be a salesperson or a trader or maybe a quant or a risk manager. So I think that for everybody, there is the chance to be satisfied and have a good performance in the trading room, if obviously they are interested, if you are interested in the subject, as I imagine that you are, because otherwise you would have chosen a different field.
Thank you very much, Simone. So now let me introduce Michele Tripletti from Banca IMI. Actually, Michele, almost 1 year ago, hired one of our former students. So Michele, the floor is yours, please.
Hi to everybody. Thank you, Rocco, for the chance to talk to your future students. So let me start by introducing myself and my work. I studied physics. I have a PhD in theoretical particle physics. I worked as a researcher, actually, in different places around Europe. My research domain was string theory. Then at a certain point, I moved into finance, first as a risk manager inside the Intesa San Paolo group, then on the business units of the bank, the so-called front office, as a derivative trader. Now I am in charge of the trading desk that manages the counterparty risk, so the so-called credit valuation adjustment, also known as CVA, and debt valuation adjustment, also known as DVA, of the Intesa San Paolo group. Professor Rocco Ciciretti asked me to tell you what I look for when I hire new people. Well, let me start from describing how my desk is composed, which may partly answer this question. And then maybe later I will try to be more specific. So the desk is composed of 5 people, including myself, each with a different background. So there is one physicist, who is me, then one computer scientist, one mathematician, who is now also enrolled in a PhD program in computer science, then 2 economists, a senior one and a junior one, very good, who studied in the very university we are talking about, in Tor Vergata, and has been hired, as Rocco said, 1 year ago, roughly speaking. So as you can see, as I want to stress, diversity is an important piece of an important element in the puzzle. Everybody adds his specific skills and backgrounds to the desk, and we really learn from each other. And in this, also curiosity is a very important element. Another thing that I want to stress is that everybody is at least potentially active in all the tasks we are asked to perform. So, as an example, the computer scientist is a highly skilled and very active trader, especially in the fixed income space. Trading is, of course, the main task of the senior economist and will become the main task also of Simone, who is the junior economist. But on the other hand, they, in particular, the senior economist, is becoming pretty acquainted with some artificial intelligence tools, which we are developing in the desk. So now let me be more specific and hopefully more clear about what I'm looking for. So I look for curious people interested, willing to learn and understand things, and with a high potential of learning and understanding things fully, efficiently, and quickly. This is something we cannot derogate from. About the specific background, the specific background one has is very important, since it represents the amount of things that one can teach to the others. But I believe there should not be any strict requirements on it. So as an example, in our job application, we usually allow any economic or scientific background or engineering or similar things. And maybe we should even be less strict about that. The important thing, I believe, is that the background, whatever it is solid and strong. And I believe one has to really like what he is studying and what he studied. Because if this is the case, whenever, by any chance, what one knows becomes important in the desk activity, then only at that point one is able to raise his hand and state, okay, guys, I know what to do here, so I will explain to you. And, I believe that ideas do not come out of the blue, but they come out of one's background, if that is strong enough. We actually have a little requirement, a little strict requirement, which is quite basic. One has to be reasonably good in math. I don't mean high-level mathematics you learn at the university course, just the standard high school math. I mean, I believe the same level of math you need in a finance course as the one we are talking about. About this, I'm not stating that a good trader must also be good in math, which up to a certain point is not necessarily true. I'm just stating that this is necessary and a specific requirement for my desk, where the risks we have to manage are pretty complex with tricky dependencies and correlations. And to conclude, just a final remark. Maybe in the slide you see there is written a small disclaimer which states that I speak for myself and not for my employer. So I'm not stating that what I need for my desk is what the bank needs and look for when hiring. But I believe that many of the things I told you are pretty generic. The point is that the financial industry needs more than ever smart people such as those I've described, since the financial industry is a world that evolves really very rapidly. The skills needed today are way different than those that were needed 10 years ago and will keep changing. So an employee who stops learning also, in my opinion, stops being useful pretty soon. And if I may give you an advice, when you prepare a job interview, when you will prepare in a couple of years a job interview, it's important you understand what an employer can do for you, but I believe it must be fully clear what you can do for the employer and how you can be useful inside a certain, I mean, when you work in a certain place, because that's the only way of understanding what you will be asked and what the job interviewer is actually really willing. And you will also understand if that job is fit for you or not. I think that's all for my side.
Thank you very much, Michele. Thank you very much to everybody. Let me check if there is some question that you students want to ask to our testimony. We can allow a couple of questions before going ahead. So let me place the employee statistics, and if some of you want to ask, please feel free to do. Any question you want to ask to the testimony we just heard? Okay, so thank you very much, and let's go ahead with our presentation. So because we do this kind of, as I told you, bridging the gap activities, and our industrial partners in different way help us interviewing you, building your career, our employment rates reached 98% after 1 year from the dissertation. And of course, we have also internship opportunity at, for example, the Italian Security Exchange Commission, that is the CONSOB, as well as, and now we move to our program overview. So it's a Master of Science, is entirely taught in English. We belong to the Department of Economics and Finance. And of course, we really push on mathematical and statistical technique to that you can use in financial market as a wide spread of activities. We have a program structure that is divided mainly in three paths. We focus on insurance, finance, and banking. And we allow for three electives overall, with respect to the 13 courses we have to took. And of course, we suggest some electives to better create your academic curriculum that will help you, as well as your final dissertation, to find, as I said, your dream job. Maybe it will not be your first job, but in the short run, and of course in the long run, you will figure out what really you want to do as a professional working in finance. Also, our master offer a lot of database you can use for your take-home, problem set, group work, and of course your final dissertation. We strongly encourage you to work on empirical data, so apply the theoretical model to observe data in the market. We help you to get the Advanced Risk and Portfolio Management Certification, the Refinitiv Certification, as well as the MATLAB Associate Certification. And we also provide with several data sets. Among those, we have also Morningstar Direct, Morningstar European Data Warehouse, VGO Iris for ESG data, so sustainable investment, as well as we have Icon and DataStream certification and data set. And we offer also scholarship to go to the quantitative bootcamp in New York of ARPM. So we really push you to find more and more the link between what you study and what you will face in the future. We also have a scholarship and grants. So, for example, the best first year student prize, graduate prize. So we have reimburse your MATLAB certification, and as well we pay you the trip to New York if you rank in the first two position. So all of this is just to push you to compete with your classmates for goods. And in this competition, there is also the dual degree program. So for those of you that want to try not only Erasmus program or thesis abroad, we have an agreement with University of Gothenburg in which two of you can go and spend 1 year in Gothenburg to get the dual degree. And as I said, we have also Erasmus and thesis abroad. Because our class is a small class, we don't allow more than, we want to stay around 35 students per year, you have a lot of opportunity. The probability that you get Erasmus, overseas thesis, or dual degree, or the bootcamp in New York is very high. So almost each of you can get something from the program that really fits your will. So our idea at the very end is that we really want you to apply to our program. We are ready to answer to any question you have, as well as what we did today with our testimony activities. And of course, there is you apply, then you have an interview with us. And then we review your interview, your English level, and all this activity to give you a prompt answer, because our program starts September 1st, 2020. And we also have this Virgilio project that is help you to get in touch with other students, and as well during the conference day to get in touch with alumni for our network. So at the very end, you can contact me directly to my personal email, or you can send email to the admission and program office to ask anything you need that we were, let's say, not able to transfer to you today, or you can visit our website. So my presentation ends here, and now please feel free to ask any question you want. So we have now an open session of Q&A with me and with the testimony that maybe some of them are still here. So please go ahead with your question if you have something. Any question?
Yes, I have one.
Yes, please. Thank you.
Yes, this Master of Science gives the opportunity to become an actuary, attuario in Italian, right?
Also, yes, we have one specific course in life insurance, and then we have two courses in advanced finance and insurance topic. That is also a flip class in which you teach to your classmates and to professor according to ARPM program. So we have three courses that allow you to go into details in insurance topic.
Okay, that it really gives the knowledge needed to be an actuary, right? Because there are courses like Scienze Attuariali, then allows to the state exam, and this course too allows to the state exam, but about the knowledge.
Yeah, we do not want to compete with Scienze Attuariali, but we want to give you a modern idea of insurance. Like we want to show you that insurance is an additional asset in financial markets. So our approach is to show that insurance is not like, we don't want to teach insurance in a traditional way. Of course, life insurance is a basic course, but advanced topic in finance and insurance one, advanced topic in finance and insurance two is a different way. We want to show that insurance is part of financial markets. This is what our aim in this specific topic.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you. Any question?
I have one question, actually.
Yes, please.
When's the Skype interview? After the deadline of the 22nd of July or before? For instance, if I apply today?
Yeah, if you apply today, let's say in 1 week, you get in the interview.
Okay.
And we already admit several students, and as I said, around 35, we closed the enrollment. We don't want to have a class of 50 students.
Okay.
Our course is 35. Our, let's say, target is 35.
Okay, so if I apply today, I have more probabilities to get accepted rather than if I apply in July?
Yes, of course. Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Good evening.
Hello.
Good evening. May I ask something?
Yes,
actually,
please.
I have two questions.
Okay, so, go ahead.
The first one is, are there scholarships for students who did the GMAT exam?
At the end of the first year, yes. And when you graduate, yes, but not before.
Oh, okay, thank you.
If you do the GMAT, you have, let's say, an express path for be admitted, because we value your GMAT really in an objective way. So if you have, let's say, a good score in GMAT, of course, you don't have to do, let's say, the math exercise, statistics exercise, or English test. So GMAT is a preferred to be enrolled.
Okay, thank you very much. And during the courses, are we going to cover the topics for the CFA exam, like the first level CFA exam?
Yes, of course, even maybe the second level. First level, when you graduate, you can do the CFA first level very easy.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you. Any other question?
I have another question for the application.
Yes.
Is it a problem if I have some exams remaining because I'm gonna graduate in October? So is it a problem if I have to do still five exams? At the moment, six exams for the graduation, but these exams are divided in July and September.
Of course not. It's not a problem. As long as you finish your exam and you graduate in October, you are admitted with, you know, with reserve. But you can, if you graduate, you can then close your enrollment path in October after graduation. No problem at all.
Okay, thank you.
Other question, please. Okay, there is some question in chat. What is about the Skype interview? Skype interview is an interview with our committee that select student, and they ask for your motivation. They ask you about your, as Michele said, your basic math level as well, basic statistic level that you did even in high school. And that is very easy. Is a conversation interview. We don't ask something that you didn't do in high school. And the task and the topic you have to cover is the basic topic, as Michele said, that is the topic you will also be requested when you look for a job in finance or in banking or insurance. And then there is another question. What about the requirement on L36? So if you want to close your gap in mathematics, it's just you have to, you can apply with L36, and you just need to study more in September that we have math and statistics, but there are the only two courses when we start our program. So September and October, you do only math and stat. That's it. So you have 2 months of full immersion in mathematics and statistics. So it's very, let's say, if you have the attitude to close the gap, you can do it. You study only these two for 2 months. Any other question? Thank you. Anyone want to ask? Okay, so let me say that I really want to thank everybody to attend the meeting. I hope that I have a question, sorry, there is one question. About if it's possible to know at the moment. Yeah, the fee you can write to them, to the program office. They will let you know any fee you have to pay that is related to your income. So it depends on your income and are all written on the web. You can go on the website and check what you will pay. And also you can write email to us and we'll give you any additional information you have. So if there are no additional questions, let me thank you again for participating in the meeting. I hope it was very interesting. Will you send a semester online? Okay. Yes, it depends on what the law will say, the government will tell us, but we are almost sure that the first semester or the first part of the first semester, until this health emergency will be recovered, we will have online classes or at most a blended classes. So maybe because we have a really small group of students, maybe if you want, you can come to the school, but we will have online. And if you come to school, we will also deliver at the same time the class if you stay at home. So we are ready to stay at home if it's needed, or come back to school if there is the health situation allow us to come back. Okay, so any other question? Thank you very much. As I said, you can send us email. Let me just show you the our address again. So This is our email address. You can write to me or to the office. And I hope to see you in September. This means that you enroll in our program. Thank you very much to our partners. Thank you everybody to attend the meeting. Bye-bye.
Bye, thank you, Rob.